Hello, everyone. Good evening. First of all, let me just thank Randhir for giving me this opportunity for the Center of Asian Blues and Vishwaneedam, as a platform for me to talk about the topic which I'm going to talk about. A special thanks to them and special thanks to my old friend Randhir. Okay, now about myself, I'm Vanamala Ramesh here. I have been a UPSC educator for the past 25 years. Presently, I'm practicing as a ICF certified positive psychology coach, where we work with people to better how they can lead a better life. The focus is more about self, happiness, gratitude, everything. Now, before I go ahead, I need to tell, I want to share what is positive psychology, because this concept is something that has caught up in the Western countries. In India, it has not been caught up so much. This whole concept, or you can say the subdivision of psychology, that is the positive psychology, started in the 1960s and the 1970s by Martin Seligman, who, after a lot of research, said that why can't we deal with something which will make our lives better? That would be the perfect definition, I would say, if somebody had to ask me what is positive psychology. The very word psychology and positive means, here we are going to focus more upon what is it that we can make our lives better. Now, that is, it is human nature. Whenever you hear the word psychology, what thing strikes in your mind is, okay, mental illness, schizophrenia, paranoia, all these things. So it was all concerned with the negative aspect of the mind. So Martin Seligman thought about, why not make use of the human personality, find out why he's sad, do some interventions with him to make his life happy. And he said, let's not go anywhere else to make your life happy. Let us see, all of us as human beings, we have our own strengths and weaknesses. Now, he did not believe in talking about our weakness points. He believed in talking about our character strength, which all of us have. It's just that how you tap your character strengths. So we do a particular survey, the VIA character strength test and all that, where we find out, what are your top five and what are your top bottom strengths. Taking that into consideration, we work upon with the clients. If your top strengths, that means you can use it to the optimum level. And sometimes what happens, your strengths also, if you use it, if you overuse it also, it is not good. Optimum use is good, overuse is not good. And not only that one, your strengths, it's not that you use your strengths on others. You will have to use it on yourself also, is what all positive psychology is about. Now, say for example, kindness. Kindness is a character strength. Say, for example, it is one of your top strengths. If you end up being kind only to others and not to yours, that means you are underusing your strength. This is where positive psychology comes in between and tells, you are underusing your character strength. You will have to use it more so that you can shape your better self. But this is all about positives. Positive psychology is all about, Now, when the very word positive means positive emotions, happiness, joy, compassion and love, all these things. Now, all these things are something that not everybody, experience or have. Happiness is something that many people try to get it, but are not able to get it. So we work with clients to find out how to help them get the happiness. And when we sit with clients or when we talk to them, we realize that, there are so many things which we as persons don't know, how we ourselves are the roadblocks. What could be the roadblocks? The roadblocks could be carrying over the past grief, carrying over something past which people have not done good to us, grudge, taking failure too seriously. Positive psychology tells us to practice these things of being grateful, forgiveness, service, So when you do all these things, automatically happiness comes to you. Now, I mean, if I have to ask, you know, whenever in a day when you do something out of compassion, out of service, when you help a poor man, or when you say anybody for that matter, when you help a poor man, help him fill in the bank details or help a man cross the road, the amount of satisfaction you get, I don't think no money can give that to you also. So positive psychology is something where you don't have to go anywhere outside. It is all there within you. You just have to practice it and realize it, like, you know, how life has been to you, how you can be grateful to people, and gratitude. We tell them to write the gratitude journal, to remember people who have helped you, to be thankful to people, to be helpful to people, all these things. Now, since the whole thing topic is about, like, you know, what can I say, old age and all that. Now, this old age, like, you know, positive psychology has done a lot of research on old age. Positive psychology believes something with called positive aging. Like, you know, how do they do it? Like, see, it becomes very important. Like, when you look at the Indian curriculum, I'm not talking about the thing. We teach everything, numerics, chemistry, periodic table, wars, waged, everything. But we don't teach anyone emotional hygiene, the gratitude, the resilience, the optimism you should have, like, you know, how to fight back during bad days, how to come over grief, then how you need to be thankful to everyone, nature, mother, like, you know, your parents, and the importance of your grandparents, parents. So when you teach all these things, when it becomes a part of curriculum, what happens is, in the long run, I don't think aged parents are going to suffer the way these days they are suffering. Because now everything what has been taught about, like, you know, they're all running in the rat race. Okay, if I don't get 98-99%, I'll not make it. So the emotional point is just lost over here. Everyone is competing, the importance of family. The moment they start working, they forget their parents, their grandparents. So one of the reasons for this, like, you know, old age is something that which I or anybody's cannot, we cannot escape. All of us one day have to go through that phase. And then to make old age a more positive stage or something, I feel we need to have a separate, like, you know, not only for old age, I would say, a curriculum where we teach children, like, you know, how to be happy, like, you know, how to show gratitude, how to have compassion towards everyone, and how to be resilient, how to have optimistic, like, you know, power. Or when you teach all these things from a very small age, like, you know, it becomes a part and parcel of you. I don't think, like, you know, old age parents have to suffer what, like, you know, they're suffering through. Now, if you do a research about old age across countries, no country or no, like, you know, spiritual, no country for that matter, never, like, you know, calls parents as to be a burden on the society or on the children. But why? Why is that old age people are suffering? That is because the way we've become, we're all running on autopilot mode. Everything is automatic. We are depending so much on digital technology, and we are in a rat race. The working cultures have become very bad. The importance of family is going away. Relationships is taking a backstage. Marriages are not sustaining. Now, all these things are because of the fast-paced world we are living, and we are not, and you're forgetting the spiritual aspect about it. Like how I said, a lot of research was conducted in different countries, like, you know, Europe, States, Japan. And it was found out that the countries which are called the blue zones, that is Japan, Greece, Costa Rica, Italy, this is the place where you have people who live the longest and the healthiest. And they're very happy. Why? When research was conducted, they realized that from the very beginning, this was something that was inculcated to them from childhood, like, you know, the importance of family, the importance of being gratitude, and how all of them would come together in a time of crisis. And how, like, you know, practicing things like gardening, close to the nature, And then they believed in this ikigai concept, where every day when you get up in the morning, you question yourself, like, you know, what is the purpose of your life? That shows that, like, you know, when you get up in the morning, you need to have a purpose. You want to do something good, not only for yourself, for your family and for your society also. And they always believed in, like, you know, not eating 100% with your stomach full. The moment you're 80%, they say enough of food. So all these are, and more spirituality, they prayed to the ancestors. They all sat down and they used to take naps for half an hour whenever they felt there was some sort of stress. So these are all the points, like, you know, we've seen that you can see positive aging in all these blue zones. Whereas in developed countries, it's very bad. In a country, like, you know, developing country, even India, I mean, I was reading somewhere the other day, in India right now, old age homes, it's become a business enterprise these days. Now, we need to find out why first before we go ahead everything. The why starts from, I would always say, like, you know, we building a strong base for our children. Telling them, see, there's no point telling them how our parents are. No, it is more about teaching them about the life skills, like, you know, how aging is a part of life, like how you need to take care of them, and how, because old age is a very, like, you know, it's like, you know, it's a very helpless stage where you're growing old, you have health issues, and all that. They feel they're useless because they're not working financially. Many of them must be dependent on the parents, some might not, but still, you know, there's so many issues that are concerned with old age. We all need to first start a curriculum with children. Like how I remember when I was studying, we had something like called the moral science classes. Nowadays, it is not there at all. It's not there. I mean, like, and see, like, when you ask many people, they say, oh, like, you know, people, see, net and social media is a knowledge, like, you know, what happens is when you get up in the morning, the first thing what you do is you open the thing, you read your mail, you see your Instagram thing. The first thing in the morning is something you should focus on yourself, like, you know, pay some attention to you, practice some deep breathing, like, you know, the very moment you're consuming this external world filled with so much of fake news, there's so much of atrocities, communal issues. These are definitely not going to help you as a person. So it is something like all these things should start off. We need to teach our children. Have you seen the way these days children are addicted to these tabs and TVs? It is definitely not going to help them. And I'm telling you, another 10 to 12 years down the line, things are going to become really worse. So to stop it, and, like, you know, like, you know, if we have to tackle this issue of, like, you know, aged parents, we need to start from the base level, from the time, like, you know, how we teach them A, B, C, D, like that. We should, in a week, one class needs to be, like, you know, taught to the children about mindfulness, like how, like, you know, when whatever you're doing, you should be present at the moment. Nowadays, like, you know, it's become a habit these days. People sit in front of the laptop and they have their lunch. No, that is not the way. You have to be mindful when you're eating also. Look at your food, look at the colors, feel the senses, enjoy. I mean, and be thankful to the farmer who's been given this to us. So we run on autopilot mode on all these issues. Like, you know, because my boss told me to work for extras, I have to work for extras. I'll have to party in the evening because I have to be socially active. But when it comes up to self, we don't pay much attention at all. So when you don't pay attention to yourself, when you don't show love to yourself, how will you show love to your aged parents is the question. So if you're taught how to do it, love yourself, love your family, and the importance of family is something that has to be taught from the very beginning. So they say the basic, like, the socialization process that starts from the first is the family for the child. It will never go away. It is inculcated deep down into his mind that he will never falter at all. So this is my view, and this is I feel like, though in India positive psychology has not like, you know, kick-started, like, you know, it's doing great in Europe and all that about mindfulness. It is nothing, very simple, simple exercises. American companies are spending thousands of dollars on mindful exercises, like, you know, where nothing, you just close your eyes, sit down, notice your breath, notice your senses, realize what is happening around you. Like, you know, the chanting, the breathing, simple. So this is something that we all have in our country. Spirituality is something we all have. Like, you know, so it's high time we tap this knowledge, this positivity, knowledge of positivity to children. So I'm sure half the problems what we are facing today, I think will be gone. I just hope I'm here on a mission, like, you know, to help people. Like, you know, I'll try my best to talk a lot about positive psychology, tell children, students. Like, you know, and this was also one of the reasons, like, you know, I shifted from UPS educated to thing, because when I used to interact with students and parents and all that, I realized that, like, you know, everybody are in a rat race. Aap kya banna chahte ho? Mere papa kehte IAS banna hai. So aap kya banna chahte ho? Is the question, like, you know, it's not that the children are always right. We as parents and mentors, we have to guide them. But sometimes we need to hear them out also, certain things. So this is what made me realize mothers, you know, all under the patriarchal setup, there's so much of, like, you know, pain they have inside. So I thought, like, you know, I mean, I always felt that we need to give back something to the society. Is one of the reasons I like, you know, upskill myself a lot in positive psychology. It's a beautiful subject. Like, you know, I just hope, like, you know, India makes use of this subject along with the great spirituality knowledge we have. Like, you know, so that we can teach everyone, and, you know, and even not only that, especially since it is all about aged parents, I think it's time we say thank you to them. They are never a burden to us. I mean, we need to understand, like, how they took care of us. It's our duty, like, you know, to make sure that they're comfortable, loved, like, you know, indulge them in many games, you know, all these things is what I would like to talk about, like, through positive psychology, I could say. Thank you very much. Thank you, Randhir, for giving me the chance to talk.
Yes, thank you, Vinisha. And it was very insightful presentation. And since we don't have participants, so okay. I will ask some questions.
Please.
What are the techniques through which we can engage old age people, you know, in dealing with their problem, like stress and all this. Yes.
See, first of all, like, you know, first thing what we should make them realize is, see, they all feel lonely, helpless because of various reasons. So first, I mean, we'll have to make them, like, you know, mindful, engage them in some nice, calm, composed thing, like, you know, and during that age, they would all like to listen to some scriptures, okay, talk to them. Lending your ear and giving and listening to them would be one of the best things you could give to old-aged people. Talk to them about, like, you know, about their families. What did they do? How did they spend their time? What was the best moment? See, what will happen is everything is going, when you talk to mom about all these things, all their emotions are going to flow out, like, you know. So when these emotions flow out, that time what we can tell is, see, naturally they're going to be sad, like, you know, see, I wanted my son to be like this or my daughter to be like this. But so you say, then you can just tell them it's okay. I mean, like, you know, just forgive them. Just forgive them. Don't carry any hard feelings. Just be happy. Tell them to sing. Tell them to dance. And they must all be having some hobby or the other. Let them do whatever they like, you know, and make sure that the stress is definitely not there. Deep breathing, sitting down and, you know, telling them to take deep breaths. It would be one of the best thing of what you could tell, like, you know, help the old age people. Have some games. You need to divide the people into groups. Some must be interested in music, some must all, you know, how to engage them. And more than anything else, sitting down and giving them your ear, nothing than that. Empathetic towards them, understanding them. Like, you know, see, Randeep, what I would tell is, it's not that all of us, everyone would have made mistakes. It's not that they would have also done. See, all of us made mistakes. We sitting down there, we're not there to correct them. Many a times, I know parents feeling, I also did a mistake. I was rude to him when I was small. I abused him. They tell us, like, but it's, but we tell them, I can't tell them, no, you did a mistake, that's why you're suffering. No, say, it's okay. Forgive him. He will also forgive you. Forgiveness is one of the best exercises where they will not have that stress. You just tell them, write it in a book and say, okay, I forgive you. I'm sorry for the mistake what I've done. So nothing like sitting down and talking to them. And sitting down, we should not give them advice. None of us should give advice. We are not here to give advice. Just talk to them. And what I'm telling you, the moment you give them advice, they're going to go back. They won't be comfortable with you. Oh, nobody wants to be told you're right or wrong, right? And especially that age, nobody wants to be told. So, and we can tell them, like, can you be grateful? Like, no, what do you like? You get onto their mind, like, you know, what do they like? What do they want to do? Is there any bucket list they have in their life? Is there something that is left behind? They have something. Talk to them. Do they like nature? What is that? And, you know, you need to find out, like, you know, how did you bring up your children? What did you do? It's all about sitting down and engaging. I know a very old person who never used to talk at all, Randeer. He's too grumpy, he used to sit and all that, like, you know. See, he might be grumpy, but we can ask, like, you know, what's your favorite sweet? Like, what do you like? They will open up, maybe not the first time, maybe not the second time, third time. See, every person would like to have some social interaction with others. And I'll tell you one more thing. Old people like to use social media a lot. The survey has said, like, you know, 74% of they love to see. So involve in them like that only. Like, you know, what you can do is, you know, there are so many Instagram, old people doing Instagram accounts. Like, you know, telling that, like, you know, I never use soap. Like, you know, I used gram. So you show to them and look, tell them, look at them this age, how lively they are. Come on, what can you do, uncle? What can you do? Like, you know, what good are you at? Like, you know, say, for example, if a lady is very good at cooking, encourage her and tell her, my God, so nice. Like, you know, see, everybody at the end of the day likes appreciation. They want, then that want feeling should be there. So many times they do say, like, you know, I was not fair to my child. I was not fair to my wife. It's okay. Forgive. Forgiveness, then being kind. There's nothing like that. They are going to forget everything. Only thing, somebody has to tell them. Somebody has to tell them, give a book and a pen and tell them, write down your thoughts. What do you feel? Don't tell them, write what are your bad. No, write everything. Tell them, we're not going to read it. We're going to throw it off. Write it in a piece of paper. Gratitude, and ask them for what their gratitude in life. You just have to, like, you know, like a child. See, like how when we were small and how we should look forward for grandmother's stories. Here, like, you know, they become the child. Like, you know, we are the over here. We're trying to get things done out of them. But no telling them, you shouldn't have done that. No. They're past that age. You have to make them more wanted, like, you know, go with the flow, like, you know, and listen to them and enjoy the small things, like, you know, and make sure that, like, you know, they say, I like to eat. We should make sure that we get them once in a way. They'll feel very happy. Like, you know, this is what I would always suggest. Just lending the ear is one of the best things what we can do to old people.
And thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And really, it was a great session your session will be, sent to all our students. Well, and tomorrow they will see this presentation. So yes. Thank you so much for your precious time.
Thank you, Randy. Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Randy.
Thank you.